whoa, Nance. Nance, where are you going?
There's just something I want to check on first.
Something you maybe want to share with the rest of us?
I don't want to waste your time. It's a real shot in the dark.
Yeah, okay. Are you out of your mind? Flying solo with this Vecna creep on the loose? No, it's too dangerous. You need someone to... Here you go. I'll stick with Nance, all right? You guys take the car, check out this shrink.
I don't think you want me driving your car.
Why?
I don't have a license.
Why don't you have a license?
I'm poor. I can drive.
No. Never again. Please, anybody but you, no. No chance.
Come on.
No.
All right, okay. This is stupid. Us ladies will stick together. Unless you think we need you to protect us.
Be careful!
You just gonna stand there and gawk?
Shut up.
Let's go.
Get in the car.
So, we gonna talk about it?
Sorry, talk about what?
Your temporary insanity earlier today when you basically threw yourself at Nance.
Okay, first of all, that's not what happened.
Pretty sure that's what happened. It was pretty public. There were, like, a lot of witnesses.
Are you implying that I still have a thing for Nance?
No, I'm not implying. I'm stating. And as it relates to your steadfast refusal to date Robin, it's pretty much the only logical explanation.
That's not the only one. And as for Nance, I was just trying to protect a friend. A friend, Henderson, okay?
Okay.
I don't want to find her in the morning with her eyes sucked out of the front of her skull by this Vecna creep.
You're, like, bright red in the face right now.
No, I'm not. I don't want to talk about it. I'll punch you so hard in your face that your teeth will fall back out.
Oh. Too far.
Not cool. Sorry.
Not cool. It's okay.
Okay, so... we have a plan. Thanks to Nancy's newspaper minions, we are now rock star psychology students at the University of Notre Dame. I'm now Ruth, and I'm Rose.
Ruth?
Nice GPA.
Thanks. So we called Penhurst Asylum, told them we'd like to speak with Victor Creel for a thesis work co-writing on paranoid schizophrenics, to which they said no. But we landed at 3 o'clock with the director. Now all we have to do is charm him and convince him to let us talk to Victor. And then maybe we can rid Max of this curse.
Yeah, about that. We've been doing our Victor Creel homework, and, we got some questions.
Lots of questions.
So do we. Hopefully Victor has the answers.
Wait a second. Where's mine? Nancy, you're out of your mind if you think I'm babysitting again.
Okay, first of all, they're not babies anymore, and Max is in real danger. She needs people around her.
I know, but why does it always have to be me?
Oh my God, you have a Tom Cruise poster.
You have a Tom Cruise poster.
That's old. It's just... can you please not touch anything?
I can't do anything here, Nance. Maybe I can be helpful with this asylum director dude. I don't know. I could, like, turn on my, like, my charm.
Not the kind of charm we need.
Ouch.
No, I just... look, I did a little digging last night, and it turns out this Dr. Hatch is a distinguished fellow of the American Psychiatric Association and a Harvard visiting scholar. Okay, this is a lifelong student of the world, and if we're gonna win him over, we're gonna have to convince him that we are too. That, like him, we are true academic scholars.
Holy shit, there's a little ballerina in here.
Academic scholar. She's giving you an academic scholar vibe? Yeah.
No, but... she will.
Oh, please tell me that you're joking.
Oh, what's wrong?
It's a spider. It's a black widow.
Okay.
Don't go in there.
Oh. Wait, just...
what? Sometimes...
just wait. Just stop moving.
Okay.
I got it.
Thank you.
If there's a spider nesting in there, you're never gonna find it till it lays eggs and all the babies spill out.
What's wrong with you? Robin, seriously. She's got problems.
Yeah, tell me about it.
It's cool that you two are like friends now. Maybe after we find Vecna, kill him, you know, save the world and stuff, maybe we can all go out or something. You know? Me, you, Robin, Jonathan when he's back. It's not like we're dating. Me and Robin. It's not like we're dating. Right? She told that, Robin?
Yes.
No, we're not.
She made that very clear.
Platonic with a capital P.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Thank you. I mean, with daters, we're friends. We're just friends.
Right. Okay, all better.
Great. Thanks.
Well, great. Guess we should get back to the investigation. The obvious things are not what people observe, or don't observe, or Sherlock Holmes.
What? Your compass has gone from wonky to wonky with a capital. Ah! Steve, what are you doing?
Somebody's got to go down there and check this thing out. Unless one of you three can top being a Hawkins High swim co-captain and a certified lifeguard for 3 years, then it's got to be me. No complaints, all right?
Hey, I'm not complaining. I do not want to go down there.
Where are we at, Wheeler?
Closing in on a minute.
Okay.
More of a snack size gate than the mama gate, but still, it's pretty damn big.
Going in there, are you?
Just wait here. No, Ned!
Nancy! God damn it!
No, you're not. You're losing blood. Come on, sit. Come here. All right. Okay.
us the good news here is that I'm pretty sure that wooziness is not a common symptom of rabies, but if you start having hallucinations or muscle spasms or you start feeling really aggressive, like you want to punch me or something, then you should totally let me know, okay? Yeah?
I kind of want to punch you.
Sense of humor's still intact. It's a good sign. Okay. Okay. You ready?
Yeah, just do it.
Too tight?
No, that's good.
You, Nancy Wheeler, have guns, plural, in your bedroom?
Full of surprises, isn't she? A Russian Makarov and a revolver.
Yeah, you almost shot me with that one.
You almost deserved it.
For your modesty, dude. Yeah, so guns seem like a pretty good idea to me.
Yeah, me too.
So what are we waiting for?
The only reason I came in here was because those ladies came in straight after you. Now, I was too ashamed to be the one who stayed behind. But Wheeler, right there, she didn't waste a second. Not one second. She just dove right in. Now, I don't know what happened between you two. If I were you, I would get her back. Because that was as unambiguous a sign of true love as these cynical eyes have ever seen.
Nancy.